Hi, I'm Kelsey from Crafting for Weeks, and today I'm going to be showing you how to do the chain stitch. So I'm going to be using Lazy Days Thick and Quick. This is from Lion Brand, and this is a super bulky yarn, which means that if you look at the back label, that little yarn ball has a 6 in it, and that tells you what size your yarn weight is. I'm also going to be using an 8mm crochet hook. No doubt if you are here trying to learn the chain stitch, you are a beginning crocheter. So welcome, and the chain stitch is really important. This is how you start most of your projects. So I'm also going to show you how to do a slip knot on your hook because you're likely a beginner. So this is how I like to slip knot. I just take my hook here. Sorry, let me get my ends all in order. And I'm going to cross this little end tail. I'm going to cross it over the top of my working yarn, and that gives me a little loop. I can stick my fingers through that little loop from the back and pull up a loop. This is your slip knot. Now you can do this with your crochet hook. This is how I like to do it. Same action, crossing that tail over your working yarn. And then instead of using your fingers, you grab it with your hook, pull it through the loop, and then you have your slip knot already on your hook ready to work. You just pull that working yarn down and that will tighten it onto your hook. There's lots of ways to do slip knot, but that's just my favorite. So now let's move on to our chain stitch. Wrap your working yarn from the back to the front of your hook. That's called yarn over. And then you're going to hold on to the base of your chain, your slip knot, and you're gonna pull that wrapped yarn through the loop on your hook. Let's do that again. Wrap it from the back to the front, pull it through the loop on your hook. This is the chain stitch. Yarn over and pull through. That's all you're doing. Now I'm exaggerating my yarn over movement to make it easy to see what I'm doing, but as you get more comfortable, you'll want to just make this motion a little bit smaller. You can do this by tensioning the yarn through your fingers, however is comfortable, and just wrapping that yarn and pulling it through. If your yarn is slippery like mine, you'll have to be more careful, but you'll just wrap it and pull through. And that is the chain stitch. Hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Like, subscribe, and check me out at craftingforweeks.com.